Maine lawmakers expect to pass a state budget and then send it to Governor LePage by this weekend. Good evening and thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Tracy Sable. The questions are, what will that two-year, $6 billion budget mean to you, and will the governor sign it into law? Our Project Economy coverage continues tonight. WMTW News 8's Paul Merrill joins us live from Augusta with some of the answers. Paul?
Tracy, we already know the budget compromise that lawmakers are debating here in the State House right now does include some tax hikes, and Governor LePage has promised to veto any budget that includes new taxes. Democrats tell us they're confident they have enough votes to override a gubernatorial veto, but we won't know for sure until those votes are cast.
Dispensed with. Is this the pledge of the House?
Members of Maine's House of Representatives take up the state budget this afternoon. The spending plan has the support of both Democrats and Republicans.
We feel it's responsible, it's bipartisan, it should get the support of two-thirds of the members in both the House and the Senate. People understand this is a much better alternative to what the governor has proposed.
Governor LePage wanted to end all state aid to municipalities. This compromise budget restores about 64% of that money. It pays for it with a 0.5% increase on Maine's sales tax and a 1% increase on the state's meals and lodging tax.
I hate tax increases, but it's just a fact of life in this particular budget.
Republican Ken Fredette supports this budget, but that may change if the governor vetoes it.
What we have to do at that point in time is talk to our caucus and see where our caucus is at. It is a different situation when you're asking people to vote for something versus an override of a governor's veto.
It's not uncommon for votes to change in the face of a gubernatorial veto. It happened earlier this week. Lawmakers unanimously supported a bill regarding prosecution against people who report drug overdoses. After the governor vetoed the bill, 47 state reps and 14 state senators voted not to override the veto. House Speaker Mark Eaves doesn't expect any flip-flops when it comes to the budget.
The governor has been so public about the fact that he is going to veto this. Those that push their green button today and vote for this budget know that they're going to have to override the governor's veto.
Now, part of the deal is those two tax hikes we mentioned are scheduled to sunset or go away after a period of 2 years. Once the budget is approved and hits Governor LePage's desk, he has 10 days to decide if he wants to veto it. Live in Augusta tonight, Paul Merrill, WMTW.